had me at a low. Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today is Hopsin Friday, and that means another reaction from Hopsin and his Ill Mind little mini series that I've got going on. I'm posting videos every Friday for Hopsin so that I can get through these Ill Mind ones, because I know there's quite a few parts. And hopefully you've seen the last videos, and the first one I reacted to was Ill Mind of Hopsin part 7, and I was absolutely blown away. So I just decided to do this mini series on a Friday and call it Hopsin Friday. And I've done a couple of others so far, so if you want to check those out, they'll be linked somewhere on the screen. Or you can go onto the Hopsin playlist that I've got on the channel here, and you can go and look those up, and obviously other reactions as well if you want to while you're there. So today's reaction is going to be Ill Mind of Hopsin parts 5 and 6. So I'm really, really excited to get into this and see more of Hopsin, because I think he is just amazing. I think he's just amazing lyrically, and just his ideas and the way he thinks and the way he words his thoughts and his feelings is just amazing. So I am very much looking forward to getting into this. So first part of Ill Mind of Hopsin is going to be part 5, and then I will follow on with the reaction to part 6 afterwards. So without further ado, let's get into the video.
Man, I hate rap, but if the shoe fits, wear it. I become a freak of nature, all the kids stare. Who walk around bumping raw with the shit blaring, saying fuck school and dropping out like a miscarriage. I'm embarrassed and I'm ashamed I played a part in this devilish game, making your common sense perish. But I ain't taking the full blame, cause most of you chumps running around here ain't never had strict parents. All of your brain cells rotting from weed. You feeling like if you ain't got it, life's not as complete. You having sex with every motherfucking body you see, with a past so dark that Satan to jump out of his seat. But still you out in these streets thinking you hot as can be, without the knowledge to lead, so you just follow the sheep, making sure your lame swag is all polished and clean, while your favorite rapper's like, yeah, he got it from me. You been brainwashed by a fake life that you used to living. When I say the word fun, what do you envision? Probably drinking and smoking out with your crew and chilling with clueless women. You trying to bang, bumping New Edition. Is that all you think life really is? Well, if so, then you're a fucking idiot. I honestly feel like grabbing your head and hitting it. Matter of fact, you don't even deserve a brain. Give me it! Do you even have any goals aside from bagging these hoes and packing the ball? Well, let me guess, no. You're only in school because your parents make you go, and all you do is play beer pong and hang out with the bros. Yo, society's got you living for a whack cause. You're a fucking adult with no skills at all. You don't read any books or play ball. You don't draw. You literally do nothing at all. Still you fiend for the glamorous fruits you don't have, cause you idolize rappers that do. And all they say is I got money in a stack to the roof. And now you think that it's gonna magically just happen to you? How? Your lazy ass don't commit to labor. You pick something up, dry it out, and put it down 2 minutes later. Then you complain about your life cause it ain't getting catered. Now whoever tries to call you on your bullshit's a hater. You wanna succeed, you have to try. Or one day you'll get older and regret it all cause you can't provide. Your friends are lowlifes, don't act surprised. Look, just cut the bad fruit off of the tree, make the sacrifice. Girls, stop acting like you want a guy with traits like Romeo, bitch, that's a fucking lie.
Wow, okay, so I'm gonna stop it there just for a minute. First impressions, this is hard. He's going hard on this guy. And I love it, I'm here for it. Wow, okay, lyrically, again, so, so clever, just such genius. And it is true what he's saying. It's kind of so many, dare I say it without sounding old, so many youngsters today put so much focus into being famous and being rap stars and trying to make a name for themselves in the music industry, or just fame in general, in show business in general. And yet actually, what is wrong with learning a skill other than being a celebrity and rap? Because obviously, rap is a skill in itself, of course. I'm not going to trivialize that at all, and what these guys do within show business, because it is hard work and there's a lot of rejection, and yeah, not everybody makes it. It is tough. But in terms of really sort of doing something with your life that's more than just being centered around being famous and being rich. What about all the other things in your life that you could be doing to actually make yourself feel fulfilled rather than just for the money and just for the fame? So I love what he's saying here about, basically he's calling out the youth of just, you know, for just kind of not wanting more for themselves, just focusing on the materialistic and things that don't really matter. Yeah, I love this. This is absolutely brilliant. It's so clever. Okay, let's carry on. I just wanted to pause it and just say that just while he had a break in lyrics, because I wanted to pause it before, but it's quite difficult because he was on a roll. So, okay, let's carry on and see where this goes.
You always talk about how every man's faking. You can't take it and you want something real. Shut up, tramp, save it. Twice a week you put on your makeup and damn bracelets and head to the club half naked with your ass shaking. Pulling a low-life nigga who claim he cash making till you let him hit and find out he work at the gas station. One of them niggas got you pregnant, man, you can't raise it. But you caused it. Your actions made a fat statement. You want Romeo to act patient and stop fronting like he in the club posted in the back waiting. It's the club where guys put on a new persona after they get loaded with a few coronas. They always shouting and wild out with habits that very few condone. Then they look for beautiful brainless bitches like you to bone them. Then when they leave you, you cry and cry, talking about, oh my god, I can't find a guy. I've spent so many years and I've tried and tried. Why am I even on earth? I should die. You want Romeo, you're not worthy. You're cockthirsty, you're nasty and probably got hurt. Sometimes the secret to find is to stop searching. Try a new formula cause your last one's not working. The term real niggas publicly used, and I need to know what it means cause I'm fucking confused. Are you one for always busting your tool with nothing to lose and something to prove? The homies up in your crew, is it because you selling drugs to get loot and brag about how you done been shot and stabbed like it's fun to be you? But your life's a struggle, right? And you just hustling through. Nah, you hamster ass nigga, you just stuck in the loop. Man, why do black people gotta be the only ones who can't evolve? Cause you in the streets acting like a Neanderthal. It's clear you can't stand the law. You lost as an abandoned dog, and all you interested in is fighting, rapping, and basketball. I can't even fuck with you, cause if we out in public, you gon' get caught stealing some shit and get my ass in trouble too. You'll get old and be nothing. Living life in these streets, thugging and starting shit with anybody mean. Wow. Mugging. Look at you, a real nigga, thinking your life's cool. Girls used to turn me down for guys who were like you, till you grab their heart and shove a spearhead right through. Then they regret it because it wasn't the right move. Your real nigga talk seems bogus. A real nigga don't brag about being real as long as he knows it, and his future doesn't seem hopeless. A real nigga stays out of jail, handle shit and he keeps focused. To all you rappers whose soul is out in the wrong, you inspire the issue I wrote about in this song. You go to pile on the young who roam around in the slums. See, this is what happens when rap's overcrowded with bums. Hope the hour's long when I'm rolling out with your tongue. The man above is my guide, you know the power is strong. All you menace and freaks are only in it for cheese, and the mass control limit was breached. Fuck hip hop. They only in it for cheese, and any eyewitness can see they purposely making the innocent weak. My existence on this planet's for you. I ain't only here to benefit me. Yo, we need to make a change while there's still time. It is hard, and sometimes I struggle trying to reveal mine. I can guide you if you feel blind. I just need you to be willing to journey into my ill mind.
Wow, he just summed up, and I don't want this to sound like a stereotype at all, but he just basically summed up what happens to a lot of the youth of today and how they can read in and take the wrong message from hip hop and what it should really be about and what living, what life should really be about. And he just did that so brilliantly, in a way that the youth would probably kind of relate to and sit up and pay attention to. And everything he was saying was so right. There are so many people out there that think that hip hop and the whole way of living is about bragging about how much money you've got, and even down to, I suppose, you know, people kind of bragging about, you know, within hip hop about how many times they've been stabbed or shot and they've come through it and look, you know, I'm still here, as if it's something to kind of be proud of, that you've kind of got into that sort of situation, into that sort of circle. And it's not really a surprise that a lot of youth get into that same thing because they hear that within the music. And as I said, I am not bad. I don't want it to come across as I'm bad mouthing hip hop at all, because a lot of hip hop is, it's genius, isn't it? It's genius in its own right. It's brilliant in its own right. And there are a lot of lessons to be learned from hip hop. It's clever, it's fun, it's sarcastic, it can be ironic sometimes. It makes some damn good points, and it gets the message out there. It gets the message across in such a clever way, and a way that people sit up and take notice. But at the same time, there are downsides to hip hop where, and I think I've said this, touched on this before in other reaction videos, the kind of hip hop I like is where it has a message, and it has deeper meanings, and it has something that makes you stop and think, and where it's streetwise, and it teaches you about the reality of life, but also kind of makes a point of, you know, not necessarily glamorizing it, like violence and drug use and things like that, but instead sort of making you stop and think, well, this is what your life would be like if you went down that road, and it's not a good life to live. And that's kind of why I'd sort of, I preferred the hip hop of sort of yesterday, the old school hip hop, sort of in the 80s, because those were kind of streetwise messages. A lot of the songs were very streetwise. They were very intelligent. They were very cleverly done. And I love to see this within modern hip hop. I think there should be more of this, where people, rather than, dare I say it, rather than there being so many hip hop songs out there where it's all about taking drugs and shooting somebody or getting shot and being proud of that and gangland style and how many women you slept with and partying all weekend and not really doing anything other than just sort of enjoying yourself. And there's nothing wrong with that, obviously, is letting your hair down. Of course, I'm not saying that, but unfortunately, a lot of the hip hop kind of glamorizes that side of life, like glamorizes that kind of lifestyle. And it's not always a good message to send out to kids or younger people that are listening to that stuff. And it gives them the wrong idea of what they should be doing with their life. And the old school hip hop was more about, you know, if you do drugs, you'll end up in a bad place. If you get into a gang and you end up getting in the middle of violence on the street, then what do you think is going to happen, kind of thing? You know, you're going to lose friends, you're going to lose your life along the way, you're going to lose yourself. And that's what I love about it, that style of hip-hop. And I love to see artists like this, which are kind of bringing it in quite an aggressive way, but they're bringing that sort of stuff to light again, and they're not over glamorizing it. They're actually making a point that, is that really what you want to do with your life? Is that all you want to aspire to do, is make a load of money, drive fast cars, sleep with a load of women, and, you know, get involved in gangs and see how many times you can get shot and stabbed to say that you've come through it, okay, and brag about that, when really you should actually be teaching your fan base not to get into that, and that it's not glamorous at all. It's not clever. It's not a great thing. And I love the fact that he touched on that in such a way that younger people would relate to that, if they're thinking that that is a glamorous lifestyle to get into, that actually it's really not, because you kind of look like a bit of a loser, for want of a better phrase. It's not clever. It's not fun. It's not glamorous. It could cost you your life ultimately. It could get you into a lot of trouble, but worst case scenario, it could cost you your life and your family and your friends and everything that's good in your life that you should be aspiring to be and to do. And I love that. I thought that was so, so clever. I'm excited for number six, for part six, if it's more of this kind of thing. I have seen a couple of comments, sort of people saying that actually his ill minds for them kind of got better from parts five and six onwards, or, you know, from here onwards. And as I said, the first reaction that I did to Hopsin was ill mind part seven. just because it had constantly come up in my recommended because of other things, I guess, that I'd watched. And I was seeing a lot of people reacting to it. And I didn't actually think, strangely enough, I didn't actually think that there were actually any other parts. I don't know why that didn't click in my brain. I just assumed it was a random title. Ill Mind of Hopsin Part 7, or Ill Mind of Hopsin 7, I think I read it. I didn't sort of think, oh, Part 7, so there are other parts before this then. Let's check those out. So the Part 7 was the first one that I reacted to of Hopsin at all. And then that's why I've decided to go back and react from the beginning and do these Ill Mind of Hopsin parts, because I was absolutely blown away by number 7. I thought it was incredible, and he made some such crazy good points and asked so many brilliant questions that we all want to know the answer to, and we probably all think about, but he had the guts to say it out loud. A lot of people are kind of, I think, scared to ask those questions because they think, oh, is it blasphemous? Am I going to get bashed for it? Because, you know, especially in terms of the religious questions and stuff that a lot of people want to ask. And he has the guts to ask those questions and to make those points. And I love that about him. And this was, again, like I say, brilliant, only it was focused on sort of the lifestyle of what the youngsters want to live, and that whole kind of hip hop culture, really, of what a lot of people seem to think that it is and what it's all about. And it could be so much more, and it is so much more. There's a lot more to it. And as I said, I don't want it to kind of sound like I'm bashing hip hop or stereotyping hip hop at all. But I just love the fact that he's kind of almost going back to how they would have done old school hip hop, where he's making some great points and he's kind of saying, that's not a glamorous lifestyle to live. That's not a great lifestyle to get into. If you think that's what hip hop is all about, is women and drugs and fast cars and partying, it's not about that. It shouldn't be about that. Your life shouldn't be about that. I'm excited to react to number 6, which I am going to do right now. So, here we go. This is Ill Mind of Hopsin Part 6. Oh, the eyes are gone.
Fucking overload on meth. Paramedic saved your ass. He was close to ghost. You never did know which road to go. It's like you rode the boat and sailed away and hoped to hit the Golden Coast. But you sank like the Titanic. The incident that left your life damaged. And that's when I panicked. You thought you had it locked, but you ain't on the right planet. If you're trying to live your life right, plan it. It's like your mind vanished. You don't even know that. I wish that we could go back, cause it's so sad when I tell jokes and you don't laugh like you used to. I really hate to stress it, but you're strange to mess with, so I keep my distance, cause you always got this blank expression. Like you confused and unaware of your surroundings. Emotions are gone and no one's found it. It's overwhelming. Your mama told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listened to the fire burned your ass. Now you understand. Like you always look like you don't know me. And I'm mad at the world cause the meth took away my homie. Give me back my homie. Please come home. I just wanna chill on the neighborhood block like we used to. Where'd you go? I never would've thought my best friend be gone in the future. But I was wrong. I should've stopped you when I had the chance to do so. But back then I felt like that was too bold. You started hanging with new folks and made the drug environment your new home. This world is too cold. Could I have prevented this? Who knows? They convinced you that the shit was cool and hip to do, saying it would lift your mood and make you feel invincible. So you started skipping school, hanging with these wicked dudes, unaware that when you got older you played a bigger fool. And it's pitiful, where the fuck they at now? In they mid-20s, passed out inside of a crack house. Back when you met them, I had doubts. They put you on the bad route, and when you needed they help to pick you up, they fucking backed out. They fucking got you, I can't lie. But now your brain's fried, you don't even act like you the same guy. Your mama told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listened to the fire burned your ass. Now you understand. Like you always look like you don't know me. And I'm mad at the world cause the meth took away my homie. Give me back my homie. Please come home. I just wanna chill on the neighborhood. ain't never felt this shit before, it gets me sore. I reminisce on us playing Nintendo 64. And that Christmas in 97, we got new crispy boards and we was doing ollies in my kitchen on the slippery floor. Shit changed and it happened quick, but I can't forget that you was the first homie I started rapping with. You could've had half of this back when I had established it, but now I have to sit and feel bad, look at what your actions did. Man, you were so outgoing and so hysterical, and seeing you now is just unbearable, it's terrible. You should've made your choices wisely, fucking with poison ivy. Without your brain, please tell me what would your point in life be? It's a struggle to get your ass to listen. You really hurt me and the rest of your family with all your bad decisions. We always told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listened to the fire burns your ass, now you understand.
You always look like you don't know me, and I'm mad at the world cause the meds took away my homie. Give me back.
Wow, okay. This is some powerful emotional stuff. Wow. Okay, I had no idea that this was gonna be a thing. Don't even quite know what to say to this. Is this something that he's talking about from personal experience? Is this kind of like one of those autobiographical songs where he lost a friend this way through drugs? Wow. That's sad. That's so, so sad. He grew up with this friend and his friend took, unfortunately, a dark path, made some wrong decisions, and he ended up like this. That's awful. Wow. Okay.
My homie, please come home. I just wanna chill on the neighborhood block like we used to. Where'd you go? Never would've thought my best friend be gone in the future.
But I was wrong.
Excuse me, do you need a ride? Looks like you're going downtown, yes. Hop in my ride. Why? I'm crystal man. I'm your best friend, crystal man. I'm all you need, crystal man. If you wanna succeed, hop in my ride. Why? I'm crystal man.
Wow, that's some really powerful stuff. That kind of goes back to what I was saying after the reacting to part five about this whole lifestyle and how it can lead people down a wrong path and they make some bad choices. And the sad part is that drugs are one of those things, and that's sad that people can get tangled up in this and they feel like it then gets to a point where there's no way out, and then this happens where it ultimately takes their life, and that's just so sad, because it's sad for the person that's going through it, don't get me wrong. It's obviously awful for the person going through it. They are going through their struggles. They are maybe trying to get clean, but it's a struggle for them because they're so addicted and they relapse over and over again. And just when they sort of try to turn their lives around, something else happens and it sends them right back again. But ultimately, if this is the result where somebody actually dies through drug use, it leaves everybody behind who cares about them in turmoil, in absolute devastation. And they're the ones that have to pick up the pieces and try and carry on without that person. It's so, so sad that people often feel that in order to fit in with a certain crowd or with a certain image and a certain lifestyle, they have to do this. They have to resort to taking drugs and just to feel accepted. I'm sure nobody wakes up one morning and sort of says, this is what I'm going to do with my life, is take drugs and just make a mess of everything and make all the wrong choices and go down a very dangerous, potentially deadly path. Nobody wakes up and aspires to be that and to do that, but that is the reality for a lot of people. And yes, it's easy for people around them to say, well, why didn't you just say no? It's not always that simple. Sometimes people use them as an escapism from a life that's not great. And sometimes people just make bad choices thinking that it's not really going to have a knock-on effect, thinking it's not really going to have consequences. And sadly, often it does. And that's the sad reality. That is the sad reality of drugs and alcohol abuse and addiction, is that it destroys lives and it can take lives. And often there's nothing you can do about it. You just have to hope and pray that they one day see the light and they one day want to do something about it. You can't make somebody want to give up an addiction. They have to ultimately do it themselves. And yeah, it would be so much easier if you could just flick a switch and someone's addiction turns off and they're fine again. It would be amazing. But they have to want to do it. This was amazing, as sad as it was, especially if it is talking about a real friend that he had that he lost to drug addiction. It takes some guts to do this kind of thing. Because I'm sure there's probably a lot of people out there saying, no, you don't need to talk about that. You don't. Well, why don't we need to talk about it though? We do. We need more artists talking about this and the knock-on effect of what addiction can have. And I commend him. I commend Hopsin for doing that and for addressing the whole situation and the reality of drug addiction. This was amazing. I mean, it was hard-hitting. It was hard-hitting, but necessary, definitely necessary, especially in today's world where so many people are facing this struggle. Everybody needs to hear this. Everybody that is experiencing that needs to hear it from the point of view of a person watching what addiction does to somebody and how it makes them feel and how it makes the people around that person feel, and just stop and think, do I really want to put people through that? The people that love me, the people that genuinely care about me, not the drug dealers who pretend to be my friend, who pretend to care, but the people that really do care, the people that are really meaningful in my life. Do I really want to put them through that? Is this what I want to do to them? Do I really want to destroy their lives like this? Because the people that give you the drugs or the people that you party with, that leads you down that dark path, they don't care about you. They really don't care about you. All they care about is getting somebody else to join their little group, to get high with, to get wasted with. That's what they care about. And it kind of makes them feel better about what they're doing, because they're thinking, well, look, I've got all of these friends that do it, so, you know, it's fine. As he pointed out, they don't really care. They just disappear. They're not the ones that are left. They'll just move on to the next person, the next victim that they can take down the dark path with them. And that's so, so sad. It kind of makes me angry as well at the same time, because you just wish you could kind of take a sledgehammer to them and just be like, stop doing it. Stop. You want to do it, fine, but stop leading other people into this, telling them that this is fun to get high and it's fun to party and it's fun to live this life. You know, oh, it's so, life's so boring. Life's not worth it if, you know, unless you're doing this. Life is so worth it if you are clean and you are sober and you are in your right mind and you can make decisions for yourself and you're not down this dark path. This whole lifestyle of getting wasted and getting high, that is not worth it. That is just, that is really not worth it. But it's really not cool. It's not cool, it's not fun, it's not glamorous. It's a waste, frankly. It is a waste. And as I said, I wish more people, more artists would address things like this, especially within the hip hop community. I'm very, very interested to see where parts 8 and 9 are gonna go. And then I think what I'm gonna do once I finish those parts, or these Ill Mind of Hopsin parts, I am definitely gonna carry on reacting to Hopsin. Even when I finished with these Ill Mind of Hopsin parts, I think I'm gonna make Hopsin Friday kind of a bit of a thing, because I just love what the guy stands for. I just love what he does in his songs, in his music. And he obviously has a lot to say. He has a very, very, very important message to put out to the world, and I want to hear it, and I want to get to know more of this guy, because I think he's just awesome. And the next video that I will be reacting to with Hopsin is the Ill Minds part 8 and 9, as I say, because I've already done number 7, so there'll be one more after this one, after this goes up. And then, yeah, as I said, I'll be reacting to more Hopsin after that as well, just as I sort of like get to it. I loved this. I'm very, very interested for 8 and 9 to see where that goes. But 5 and 6, yeah, absolutely brilliant. Apart from 7, I think so far these two are my favourite ones because of how hard-hitting they are and how meaningful they are. If you love this too, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe so you can keep up with more Hopsin reactions and reactions from other artists. And I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.